Okay, the whiskey taking my control. I've been slaving at this shit, so my chain be gold. I've been feeling like I need a dose. Jack spilling on my clothes. Some mango chase just to soothe the throat.
Hi guys, so it is morning around 11:30 on the second weekend of July. I could have sworn it was the first weekend, but I made sure to double check with my mom and she's like, no, this is the second weekend. Anyway, it feels like time has been flying. This is my third vlog of the month. Today is a Saturday, but it's not going to be a rest day. I did get to sleep in nicely. Had a really, really good, deep, refreshing sleep. And now I'm having my breakfast. Ever since the massage that I had at the spa, which was about 2 days ago, I did also vlog it. You would have seen it in the last vlog. I've been having really, really nice sleeps. It was so relaxing. And I've been sleeping at normal times because you guys know throughout Vloon and even before that, I always complain that I end up sleeping really late and then waking up really late. But for the past two nights, I've actually slept at a proper time, like around midnight or very soon after midnight, which is good for me. And I've been able to wake up at a proper time in the day. So I'm touching wood. And in lieu of any actual wood close by, I am touching my head, hoping that this can continue for at least some time because I am enjoying it. I got my tea and my egg sandwich in front of me. I'm just going to get done with breakfast and get on with the rest of the day. There's quite a lot on the agenda today, even though I plan to be at home for most of Saturday at least. So I hope I can get all of it done and there is no time to waste. So I told you guys that I was in a bit of a hurry to get stuff done today. But then I ended up going to the bedroom and I was having my breakfast and I said, let me just watch one episode of NCIS while having breakfast. And one episode turned to three. I even had my second cup of tea. But anyway, it's Saturday, so if you take things at a slower pace, it's fine. Now I've made myself slightly more presentable. As you can see, got out of my PJs, put on the basic amount of makeup and tied my hair into this small little braid, which I'm sure is really untidy because even my mom was like, that's really untidy, but I just wanted to make some sense of my hair and the braid was super simple. In early July, I did a huge amount of Amazon pantry shopping. It's nothing glamorous. Amazon pantry is just stuff for the home, so it includes like food items, kitchen stuff, snacks, household cleaners, personal care and pet stuff. It's a separate section of Amazon India. And the boxes have been lying there for a few days. It's pretty bad. But I really wanted to film this haul, so I've kept them there. They're in front of me now. And we are going to smash out this haul. We are going to film it so I can put it up really soon. Hopefully I will get it up tomorrow or in the next few days on this vlog channel, because my casual Amazon hauls go on this vlog channel. So you guys can look forward to that and I hope that excites you. So my mom is here now. Hi mom.
Hi.
Please say hi to all of your adoring fans.
Hi everybody.
I always tell her and I tell some of you guys who email me also, she's very aware that though this channel is called Magali Vlogs, she's the real star of this channel. And though you make a really big fuss to actually cover the vlogs and you're like, no, why me? I don't want to be there. But now I was like, please. Please comb your hair and come in my vlog. So she's come. Are you happy to be here or are you being forced?
50-50. 50-50,
yeah? That's not a bad response. Just going to get this haul done. I'm not even sure what all I bought. Like, obviously I have a vague idea because I purchased it myself. But I can't remember properly. Let's just get started with it. Mom is just helping me test out angles. Like, I'm going to be sitting where she is, so we're just figuring out camera stuff. And of course the cats had to come to say hi. Of course. Why do they want to interfere with us all the time, mom?
It's just that they are part of our family, so they feel we are doing something, so they want to be part of it. Say hi everybody.
Meow. No, that was me. He only meows for food. You have no respect for this family. Why are you stepping on that box? Okay, he's gone. That's good. Bye. That is our little flower boy. He's so cute, no? It's like his favorite basket. This guy was very happy sitting here throughout the hall because we also did buy cat food, so he was very excited here. He was like so super excited. Yeah, here is a big pack and a smaller pack, and he's like, give me it, give it to me. He can never stop eating, like he can eat the entire day. Do you remember when he and his brother were young and they robbed the cat food, mom?
So much late.
Can you quickly like tell us that story of when he and his brother robbed the food? Like they were pretty young, right?
Must have been about 3 months old.
Yeah.
And we had bought a lot of cat food.
And we made the mistake of leaving it unsupervised, right?
Yeah, in the balcony. I was busy in the kitchen and suddenly I went looking for them and I saw them in the balcony. They had ripped open one packet and finished off quite a bit, I think, but they were stuffed and completely...
They couldn't even move. They just couldn't move. They were just sitting there like, oh my god, we're so full.
Just overdid it.
Completely overdid it. And you boy have been overdoing it your entire life. Every time we take him to the vet, we get like kind of stern scolding that he's overweight. But my parents don't have the heart to control his diet.
He's a healthy boy.
Don't say that. That's the excuse all Indian parents use.
I didn't use it on you.
You didn't have to. I was skinny. People regularly asked you if you didn't feed me enough. But yeah.
That was a truth. I was keeping you hungry.
That's why I was thin, right? Now how I'm fatter?
I mean, now you're big, you're whatever. You're demanding, you're eating too much. That's how you put on weight.
Is that so?
Mm-hmm.
Now I have to work on taking all this stuff to the kitchen. So mom and I are going to do that. And we're going to try to see how to sort it. Ah! No!
You put it out. Like, with his weight.
No.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh! I'm so sorry!
What are you?
He's in a box, and I think he's pretty confused right now. So she didn't come throughout my video, right?
No, she was fast asleep.
Now you wanted her to say hi?
Yeah.
So tell her to say hi.
Hi everybody. Say hi. Hi everybody.
She's least interested. Also, those of you guys who watch Vloon regularly, like every single Vloon, you'll probably remember that in one of my vlogs, I was complaining that my stash of cola flavored Haribo gummies and just another brand also, I mainly prefer Haribo though, from Bangkok was finished, and I intentionally did not buy too many just because I know that gummies probably aren't healthy, and I know that once I get started, even one packet is not enough. I think I had 3 packets one night. I just find them very addictive. So I saw that Alpenlibe had come out with their own copy of Haribo gummies called Alpenlibe Just Jelly Cola Bottles with 25% fruit pulp. So I absolutely had to try it, and you guys are going to see it when the Amazon haul is out, but I really couldn't wait to taste the pack. So I opened up a pack and I thought I'll tell you guys what I think of them, especially compared to the Haribo gummies. So these people call it jelly. They don't say it's gummies, and from the moment I tasted it, I realized this is more like a jujube or a jelly than a gummy, because gummies are supposed to be like kind of stretchy and they have this viscosity to it, and you really have to work your jaw when you're eating gummies. But this is just, it's very soft, so it does not have that gummy texture, but it does have that cola flavor, and it is coated with sugar. So whether that's good or bad, I'm not sure, because Haribo doesn't coat their gummies with sugar, but some smaller brands do. But I'm just excited because these are easily available now here. And whenever I feel that craving for cola gummies, I'm just going to have one of these packets instead. And it's fairly cheap at just 25 bucks. So thought I will share my excitement with you all. And since I was vlogging every day in June for Vloon, I had simply gotten so used to showing you guys like everything that comes in my mail, every single shopping order, every PR parcel. So I got these two things, I think yesterday and day before, or was it? It was all yesterday, I think. And I just felt weird that I was opening the packet and not vlogging it because I just gotten very used to it. So this is the first thing that I got. It's a McDonald's Happy Meal toy that McDonald's sent over. It's a Despicable Me 3 Happy Meal toy, and this is the Rocket Racer Minion. So this is kind of what the toy looks like, and I think McDonald's is running a limited time Minion menu as well, so there are like some desserts, snacks, etc. I find Minions a little annoying, but my dad loves them. She's just chilling inside already, na? These people and their boxes. Very strange. What happened? Someone called you. So pretty. While I was talking to her, Small climbed into that box. And Thelma is just like chilling in the background. Like, I am above all this. And she's eating tape again. She loves eating tape. They all love eating tape. They especially like licking the sticky side of tape. Next, I got this beautifully gift wrap box from Hair and Care, which I've obviously opened. Hair and Care sent over their new fruit oils. So apparently, these are like first of its kind. And I also have to admit that I don't know of any fruit oils for hair before this. Like, I know of almond oils and different Ayurvedic infusions, but this is supposed to be having fruit extract and stuff. This is the moisturizing fruit oil, and it has olive, mosambi, which is sweet lime, and green apple. And this one also says moisturizing fruit oil, but this has orange, anar, which is pomegranate, and strawberry. Also in the box is this super cute sort of floral and fruity citrusy wreath for the hair. Want some fruit oil? He has this habit of staring at us when we are doing stuff, and the minute we look at him or ask him what's happening, he just acts like he wasn't staring. Oh, that's cute. That's cute.
Brotherly love.
Brotherly love, yeah, that's very cute. I still have some cleaning up to do, as you can see in the background. But Mom and I were both kind of hungry after filming the haul, so we decided to take a break and eat. So today I'm having some mixed veg rice. It's sort of like pudlao cum jeera rice, I'm not sure exactly. And these are just two types of chicken. This is like a chicken appetizer, this is a chicken gravy, and a few sauteed vegetables at the side. So it's a bit later in the evening now. I think it's around 6 something, I'm not really sure. I left my phone that side, but it's still fairly bright. So that's what I would assume the time is like. Very, very clear sky. So there's no sign of rain today. And I guess I secretly hope it doesn't rain tomorrow also. But let's just see about that. Saturday went quite different to what I had planned it last night. This is why I don't really plan out days too much. I did get work done, so I'm not disappointed. But I was supposed to go out this evening to meet someone. But that was like a soft plan, and that has got pushed to tomorrow evening. And also, I had planned to do something else that didn't work out. But maybe I'll do it sometime in the week. And I'll try to vlog that day as well, because I think that it will be exciting. So I'm just glad that the haul got done though, because I really, really wanted to film the Amazon haul. The boxes were lying there, and now that's done. Tomorrow's Sunday, and I'm going to see the new Spider-Man film with my friend Priyanka. And it's really a pleasure to see movies with her. Not just because she's my friend, but she's like a real proper comic book geek. I consider myself a little geeky, but I don't really read comic books. So she always comes with so much of knowledge, and she explains storylines to me. And so that's why it's just even better to watch any kind of geeky film with her, I think. A little later in the evening now, I'm not sure of the exact time. It's probably like 6-ish or a little after 6. It's quite bright today, so I'm finding it hard to tell, and my phone is that side. That's what I used to look at the time. So yeah, just getting lazy like that. And I think I had a really good day. Saturday went completely the opposite of what I'd planned, which is why I rarely plan stuff. One main thing that I wanted to get done, which is film the haul, that got done, so that was really, really nice. But a few of the other things that we had planned just sort of didn't work out, and it's no big deal. I was supposed to head out this evening to meet a friend, but that has been pushed to tomorrow evening. And I was also supposed to do something with my hair today. That's what I planned. But we just got tired after filming the haul, so we might do that sometime next week. And I will try to vlog it. Let's just see exactly how things go. I'm excited about tomorrow because I have a movie date with my friend Priyanka. We're going to see the new Spider-Man film. And I'm really excited about that. It's always a pleasure to watch stuff with Priyanka. Especially geeky or comic book films, because she is a proper comic book nerd. Like, I consider myself geeky and nerdy, but I haven't really followed comics that much. So when we went for the Wonder film, also, she just brings a lot more knowledge and background to the films. So it's interesting for me to see stuff with her. And I heard that there are going to be 2 post-credit scenes after the film, because it's a Marvel film, so I need to keep that in mind. I'm a really huge fan of Sam Raimi, and I have liked his work, Sam and Rob Tappert's work, ever since I saw Xena when I was really little. And that's why I really love the first series of Spider-Man films with Tobey Maguire. And I never watched the Amazing Spider-Man films at all with Andrew Garfield. I was just so annoyed that they were rebooting the franchise, and I decided to stay very loyal to the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man. But Tom Holland really looks so cute. We've already seen him in Captain America Civil War, and I think he's been getting fairly good reviews. So that is enough Spider-Man talk for now. Our movie date is quite early in the morning, so I'm not going to get to sleep in. But I figured it was a smart thing to do, because malls on Sundays otherwise get pretty dang crowded. I'm already feeling like a little bit lazy and a little bit tired for today. So I will just get back into my pajamas, and I will definitely do some editing. As of today, which is I think the 8th of July, I have edited and uploaded 29 of my vloons of my June vlogs. So tomorrow, the 9th, I will upload the final one. And I want to say thank you again for being really patient with all my vloon vlogs. I feel bad for myself and for you guys, because I was kind of sick towards the end of vloon and I was in pain. But I really just wanted to complete it, and I did. A lot of you guys are asking for more vlogs. So as you can see, that's happening. I'm trying to vlog multiple times a week. I can't give you guys an exact schedule. I can't exactly say that, yes, I will vlog twice every week, or yes, I will vlog thrice every week, because it just depends on what's going on in my life. But I am trying my best to vlog very, very often. I have an evening of watching TV shows and getting editing done ahead of me. So none of that is really vlog worthy, which is why I'll bid you goodbye right now. And I will see you all really, really soon. Bye.
Don't mean the global shit been popping off. Lately feeling cooler than some Haagen-Dazs. These older bras, pure and cross their shoulder at my older bra. See them though, earn some bread and burn it like we making toast. It's what we chose, ain't got time to waste it, always feeling froze. And I'm just 3 months in, dropping out a simple 10. Make it off the net, cause this rap should be like Wimbledon.